Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins.
God's mercy endures forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from Joel. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sound the alarm on my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming. It is near, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness. Like blackness spread upon the mountains, a great and powerful army comes. Their like has never been from of old, nor will be again after them in ages to come. Yet even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. Rend your hearts, not your clothing. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishing. Who knows whether he will not turn and relent and leave a blessing behind him, a grain offering and a drink offering for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the aged, gather the children, even infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her canopy. Between the vestibule and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep. Let them say, spare your people, O Lord, and do not make your heritage a mockery, a byword among the nations. Why should it be said among the people, where is their God? Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Let us read in unison Psalm 103. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy, slow to anger and of great kindness. He will not always accuse us, nor will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our wickedness. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so is his mercy great upon those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our sins from us. As a father cares for his children, so does the Lord care for those who fear him. For he himself knows whereof we are made. He remembers that we are but dust.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Corinthians. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, at an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful, yet always rejoicing, as poor, yet making many rich, as having nothing, and yet possessing everything. Therefore, it is by God's mercy that we are engaged in this ministry. We do not lose heart. We have renounced the shameful things that one hides. We refuse to practice cunning or to falsify God's word. But by the open statement of the truth, we commend ourselves to the conscience of everyone in the sight of God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "Beware of practicing piety before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have received your reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may not be seen by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
I have mixed feelings about Ash Wednesday. I both profoundly appreciate the reality of acknowledging that I am an imperfect human being. And yet something about the language and the actions of Ash Wednesday seem to clash with the truth that I know, which is that every child of God is created in the perfect image of God, the Imago Dei. And I know that no matter what I do or what I do not do, I cannot break or remove the Imago Dei that dwells within my very being. And the same goes for you. Nothing you do or do not do can break or remove the perfect image of God dwelling in the core of your being. And yet, I know, oh, do I know very well, that on some days I am a hot mess, and others who look at me likely have a hard time seeing the Imago Dei within me. And so, Ash Wednesday, the profound moment of recognizing that I am imperfection wrapped around perfection. A mixed feeling that leaves me sometimes confused, disturbed, chaotically off-centered. Imperfect perfection. Ash Wednesday mixed feelings. Then, several years back, I was hiking through the pine trees of eastern North Carolina, listening to a podcast, when a poem by a man named Christian Wyman spoke into my ears, Birthing Peace. In this poem, entitled Every Riven Thing, Wyman describes the action of God towards God's creation. Riven is an old-fashioned word akin to the word asunder, which we hear in the wedding liturgy as in, what God has joined together, let no one tear asunder. Wyman says this about his use of the word riven. Riven means broken, Wyman says. It means shattered or wounded or unhealed. And I think that notion, he continues, is very important to me and to my notion of God and religion, that we are broken creatures, very broken creatures. And I don't think of God as necessarily healing that brokenness as much as participating in it. That's hard to think about, brokenness. In our contemporary culture, the idea of failure, of culpability, of our participation in brokenness is not a popular idea. And yet, there is Ash Wednesday, the profound moment of recognizing that I am imperfection wrapped around perfection. An imperfection saturated through and through with the perfect divine image of God. A both and, broken and whole, together. That there is no place where God is not, even within my brokenness. Here's Every Riven Thing by Christian Wiman. Every Riven Thing. God goes, belonging to every riven thing he's made, seeing his being simply by being the thing it is. Stone and tree and sky, man who sees and sings and wonders why. God goes, belonging to every riven thing he's made, means a storm of peace. Think of the atoms inside the stone. Think of the man who sits alone trying to will himself into stillness where God goes, belonging to every riven thing he's made. There is given one shade, shaped exactly to the thing itself. Under the tree, a darker tree. Under the man, the only man to see, God goes, belonging to every riven thing he's made. He's made the things that bring him near and made the mind that makes him go. A part of what man knows, apart from what man knows, God goes, belonging to every riven thing he's made. God goes, belonging to every riven thing he's made. So here's to Ash Wednesday. Here's to the sweet knowledge of the imperfect, saturated through and through with the perfect divinity of the one who is perfect. Here's to both and, to broken wholeness, to the Imago Dei embraced by the hot mesh of human flesh. Here's to God going, belonging to every riven thing God's made. Dear people of God, the first Christians observed with great devotion the days of our Lord's passion and resurrection, and it became the custom of the church to prepare for them a season of penitence and fasting. This season of Lent provided a time in which converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism. It was also a time when those who, because of notorious sins, had been separated from the church of the faithful, were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness and restored to the fellowship of the church. Thereby, the whole congregation was put in mind of the message of pardon and absolution set forth in the gospel of our Savior, and of the need for which all Christians continually have to renew the repentance and faith. I invite you, therefore, in the name of the church, to the observance of a holy Lent. By self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, and by reading and meditating on God's holy word. And to make a right beginning of repentance and as a mark of our mortal nature, let us now kneel before the Lord, our Maker and Redeemer.
Almighty God, you have created us out of the dust of the earth. Grant that these ashes may be to us a sign of our mortality and penitence, that we may remember that it is only by your gracious gift that we are given everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Amen.
Have mercy on me, O God,
according to your loving kindness. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses. Wash me through and through from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight.
And so you are justified when you speak, and upright in your judgment. Indeed, I have been wicked from my birth, a sinner from my mother's womb. For behold, you look for truth within me, and will make me understand wisdom secretly. Purge me from my sins, and I shall be pure. Wash me, and I shall be clean indeed. Make me hear of joy and gladness, that the body you have broken may rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me the joy of your saving help again, and sustain me with your bountiful spirit. I shall teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from death, O God, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness, O God of my salvation. Open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Had you desired it, I would have offered sacrifice, but you take no delight in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit. A broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise.
We acknowledge that in these uncertain times, the imposition of ashes will have to be done in different ways. We want you to know that there are various locations and hours available around the diocese where you can go to receive ashes. For a list of those times and locations, refer to the back of your worship leaflet or go to edfw.org. Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return. Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return.
Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return.
Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return. Most holy and merciful God, we confess to you and to one another and to the whole communion of saints in heaven and on earth that we have sinned by our own fault in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven. Have mercy on us, Lord. We have been deaf to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit.
Have mercy on us, Lord.
We confess to you, O God, all our past unfaithfulness, the pride, hypocrisy, and impatience of our lives.
We confess to you, Lord.
Our self-indulgent appetites and ways and our exploitation of other people. We confess to you, Lord. Our anger at our own frustration and our envy of those more fortunate than ourselves.
We confess to you, Lord.
Our intemperate love of worldly goods and comforts and our dishonesty in daily life and work.
We confess to you, Lord.
Our negligence in prayer and worship and our failure to commend the faith that is in us.
We confess to you, Lord.
Accept our repentance for the wrongs we have done, for our blindness to human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty.
Accept our repentance, Lord.
For all false judgments, for uncharitable thoughts toward our neighbors, and for our prejudice and contempt toward those who differ from us.
Accept our repentance, Lord.
For our waste and pollution of your creation, and our lack of concern for those who come after us.
Accept our repentance, Lord.
Restore us, good Lord, and let your anger depart from us.
Favorably hear us, for your mercy is great.
Accomplish in us the work of your salvation,
that we may show forth your glory in the world.
By the cross and passion of your Son, our Lord,
bring us with all your saints to the joy of his resurrection.
Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desires not the death of sinners, but rather that they may turn from their wickedness and live, has given power and commandment to ministers to declare and pronounce to the people being penitent the absolution and remission of their sins. God pardons and absolves all those who truly repent and with sincere hearts believe the Holy Gospel. Therefore, we beseech God to grant us true repentance and the presence of the Holy Spirit, that those things may be pleasing which we do on this day, and that the rest of our life hereafter be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to God's eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
May the peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.